Cowboy Bob Orton was one of the first second-generation superstars in WWE history. At the age of just 22, Orton defied his father's wishes and decided to follow in the footsteps of Bob Orton Sr. Using a combination of natural ability and superstar pedigree, Orton immediately made an impact, being named Rookie of the Year. Orton earned a reputation within the industry as one of the most gifted technical wrestlers of his time. But he's probably best remembered for a cast he wore for what could only be termed as a lingering arm injury.
Certainly one of the more controversial aspects of both of you would be this cast that you've worn for some time now. Bob Orton, how's the injury coming along?
Not too good, Vince. Just won't get well. See?
I'm afraid you reacted before I touched you that time.
Making the most of a bad situation, the cast became Orton's trademark.
He used the cast as a weapon. You cannot use it as a weapon. Should have been disqualified for it.
Who could forget Orton's involvement in the main event of the inaugural WrestleMania as he attempted to aid Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and Rowdy Rowdy Piper in their match versus Hulk Hogan and Mr. T. It was a match that was voted one of the top 10 in WrestleMania history by the superstars of the WWE. Orton also took part in the historic and record-breaking WrestleMania III, teaming with Don Morocco in front of 93,000 fans at the Pontiac Silverdome. Today, Cowboy Bob Orton's legacy lives on, not only for his own accomplishments, but also through his son and his protege, third-generation superstar, and the youngest WWE champion of all time, Randy Orton. Randy has some very big shoes to fill. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the WWE Hall of Famer, Cowboy Bob Orton.